लेट्स स्टार्ट।
कीप द रोलर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू हॉरिजॉन्टली एंड ब्रिंग द राइट फुट ओवर द रोलर एंड प्रेस द राइट हील डाउन, लेग एब्सोल्युटली स्ट्रेट एंड ब्रिंग द लेफ्ट फुट फॉरवर्ड। सो वी आर डूइंग द काफ स्ट्रेच। स्ट्रेटन द राइट लेग and press the heel towards the surface. You can slightly bend the left leg. Right leg absolutely straight, press through the balls of your toes into the roller. And heel pressing down. Stay there. Just push the knee towards the back. Right leg absolutely straight, we are stretching the calf. The leg is absolutely straight, parallel to the other leg. Don't bring the right leg forward and the left leg back. It has to be parallel, both the legs. You should feel your calf and your ankle stretching. And just walk on the roller, massaging your foot. Keep rolling. Couple of rounds. And switch and change. Take the balls of your left foot onto the roller. Both the legs parallel to each other. And press the left heel towards the surface. It's a deep calf stretch. Please don't pressurize yourself, but it really allows the entire calf muscle to lengthen and even the ankle tendon. Stand tall. To deepen the stretch, those who are very flexible can bend the right knee. Hold it. And massage your foot. Press nicely onto the roller and then massage. Feel the trigger points of your foot. If you want a harder massage, you can use a tennis ball. And relax. Pick up the roller. Lift your arms up. Inhale over here, legs parallel to each other, hip distance apart. Exhale and bend towards your right. Inhale and center. Exhale and bend towards your left. Just move along your breath. Inhale and center. Exhale and bend towards the right. Inhale and come up. Exhale and towards the left. Inhale and center. One more time. Exhale and bend towards the right. Inhale and center. And exhaling, lengthening towards the left. Inhale, come back center. Exhale, draw the roller behind your back, pressing your shoulder blades into each other. And draw the arms towards the center. Press the arms behind your back and towards the center. Don't inflate your belly way too much. Draw the arms behind your back and center. Don't move your head and neck. Arms are straight. Just take your arms behind your back. Neetaji, we are just taking the hands back. Don't press the elbows down. And forward. And back. And forward. One more time. Back and forward. And bring the roller in front of your chest. Inhale here. Exhale and rotate towards the right. Follow your gaze along the roller. Inhale, center. Exhale and rotate through your trunk towards the left. And center. And towards the right. And center. And towards the left. And center. And from here, inhale, arms up. Exhale and start bending forward, softening your knees. Roll through your spine down. Put the roller in front of your feet. Those of you who are not flexible enough on the hamstrings can bend the knees. And place your palms onto the roller. And you are going to roll the roller forward. Straighten the legs and look in the front, concave lower back, extended spine. And roll the roller back, round through your spine, take your head towards your knees. Inhale and roll the roller towards the front. Straighten the legs and look in the front, open the chest. Roll the roller in, bend the knees, take the head closer towards your knees. And once again, rolling the roller forward through your palms, look in the front leg straight. And roll the roller in. Slightly bend the knees and take the head closer towards your knees. And one more time. Roll the roller forward. Look in the front. And roll the roller in. This time if you would like, don't bend the knees. Just roll the roller in and take the head closer towards your knees. And slowly from here, roll the roller away from you. Come down onto the surface. And have the roller on the right side, feet towards the left side, sitting into a mermaid. So it is going to be a movement along the roller work. This is how we work in Pilates with the roller, not the conventional way how you do it in the gym. So your palm is going to stay on the roller. Take your left arm up, round your hips into the surface. Inhale here. And a long exhalation, slide the roller and bend towards the right. Even if your forearm is coming on the roller, roll it. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. And exhale. Please sit in butterfly position or cross-legged. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. From here, turn around with your left palm and your torso towards the roller. Look in the front, both the palms are on the roller, so you are doing a rotation through your torso and you are moving the roller forward, coming ahead with your torso, roll the roller forward, away from you and pull the roller in, lift through your spine. Inhale here, well done. Exhale and roll the roller away from you. Lower your upper body towards the surface. Inhale and exhale. Roll back. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. One last time. Inhale. And exhale, roll the roller away from you. Stay there, look in the front. If you can, lower the head, keep stretching. And take two deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Roll through your spine up. And pick up the roller. Place it onto the left side, palm onto the roller, right arm up, in breath over here, exhale and mermaid side bend onto the left side and just give me tiny pulses. X, one, two, three, four, five.
And slowly come back to the center. Change the crossing of the legs. Bring the legs towards the right side. Just enjoy the movement. It's very beautiful to open your softer tissues. And this time the roller stays there onto your left side. And the same movement what we did on the right side. Lift your right arm up. Hips grounding down. If you cannot sit in mermaid, you can sit in butterfly position. Inhale over here. Exhale and lengthen through your side. Right side and roll the roller away from you and bend towards the left. In breath and exhale. In breath and exhale. Roll the roller away and just do the movement along the roller. So your body is dancing to the tune of the roller. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. One last time. Inhale and exhale. Turn around, inhale. Place the palm onto the roller and once again roll the roller away from you. Lower your upper body towards the floor. Just breathe. In breath over here. Exhale and roll the roller back. Start lifting up through your spine. Inhale and exhale and take the roller away from you. Just keep on rolling and just lower your upper body. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. The slower the movement, it is going to work better onto your deeper levels. Inhale and exhale. Pull the roller in. And inhale over here. Exhale. Keep stretching through your spine. Keep lowering yourself and stay there. Hold it. Lengthen through your spinal column. Maintain the rotation. Inhale here. Exhale and come back up. Inhale and pick up the roller. Exhale and lower it onto your right side. Have the palm over here. In breath over here. Exhale and dip towards the right. And give me tiny pulses. X, one, two, three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Inhale and come back center. Release your arm. And from here, let's sit onto the roller. I know you are getting cramps. That is the sign of a lot of tightness. Okay, drink some water, please. That's also because of the fluid. Maybe the fluid is not enough in your body. So after this session, everyone, please replenish yourself, hydrate yourself well with a lot of water, okay? Because when we work on the fascia, it squeezes out, it drains out a lot of accumulated water in our body. That is called the lymphatic drainage. And that's why we need to have fresh water in our system. Okay, now from here, just bring the palms on the roller and we are going to do the pelvic rocking. Okay, what we did do lying down, just same way. So inhale and exhale. Rock forward and back. Sitting onto the tailbone on the roller. Rock forward and back. Forward and back. Forward and back. Just keep rocking couple of rounds. Forward, back, front, back. One more time. Front, back, and straighten your legs. Curl the toes towards you. Sit upright with your torso. Inhale, arms up. And exhale, come forward. Grab your toes. towards you and look in the front. Stay there. Keep pressing into the roller. Hold it. Take the mid back in and look in the front. Notice that nice extension and length into the back of your legs. And inhale, rise up. Exhale, release your arms. From here, you are going to bring the roller under your feet. We will just watch this movement first, then lie down. You will lie down and you're going to open your feet into a V. V position, opening the toes towards the side. After this, while you're lying down, you're going to bring the feet together, circle it inwards and pull the feet closer towards your sit bones. And open up, open in a V. Opening the feet in a V, circle it in and pull it in. Open it into a V, circle it in and pull it in. Okay, so let's lie down. It massages the outer and the inner side of our feet. Straighten your legs. Open the feet into a nice V. And circle the feet inwards and pull the roller in towards your sit bone. Open the legs into a V and roll the roller away. Turn the feet in and pull the roller towards your sit bone. Open your knees, open your legs into a V and roll the roller out. And turn in. And roll the roller out. Just move with the movement and in. And roll the roller out. And in. And roll the roller out. One more time. And in. And roll the roller out. And from there, do external rotation through your hip and your legs and pull the roller through your calf and your ankle. So the knees are to the side. And roll out. Pull the roller through your ankles and your calves and roll it out and in. Maintain the external rotation and out and in and out. Two more times and in and out and straighten the legs. This time press your feet into the roller. Keep the legs bent. Legs parallel to each other. Okay, pressing the palms by the sides. We are going to go into bridging. Imprint your spine into the surface. Brace your belly in towards your spine. And don't draw the feet way too away from your sit bones. Draw them closer. If you feel a catch or cramp in your hamstring, just release the work. Okay, we are not going to do it. Press the palms firmly into the surface by the side. Lengthen the back of your neck. Look towards the sky. Inhale, prepare yourself. Exhale and pressing through your feet into the roller. Lift into a bridge. In breath and exhale. Slowly roll through your spine down. And roll the roller out. Roll it out. Pull the feet in, keeping them bent. And lift up into a bridge. And roll down through your spine, coming out of the bridge. And roll the roller out, straightening your legs. Pull the roller in. And lift up through your spine. Slowly roll down. And straighten your legs, massaging your legs onto the roller, flexing your feet. And pull the roller in. And lift up into a nice bridge. And come out of the bridge. Roll the roller away, straighten the legs, flex the feet. One more time. Pull the roller in. Come up into a bridge. Lower yourself very slowly, every vertebrae after another. And straighten your legs, pull the feet away, flex the feet. This time, bend the legs, come up into a bridge and start rolling onto the roller with your feet. Come on, maintain the bridge and roll. Five, 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly come down very gently. Step yourself down, and from here, come up. Put the roller under your sacrum. Come up. So just sit. Don't have it under your lower back, please, okay? Not on the curvature of the lower back. Just below your sacrum. And lie down. Keep the legs bent. Now we are going to go into deeper work, okay? So now from here, shoulders rolled in. Don't flare your ribs. Soften your ribs inwards. Belly also hugged in. Keep pressing through your sacrum into the roller. Neetaji, is there a problem? Just lie down. Keep the legs bent and lie down. You can even grab the roller from the side. No, that is not the way. Come into sitting position and then lie down. Or just lie down into a bridge, lift yourself up and fix the roller. Lie down into a bridge. Yes, now fix the roller. That's good. So you can choose to grab the roller from the side if you're sliding off. Now draw the belly in, soften your ribs in, maintain the pelvic tilt, okay? Don't hyperarch your lower back. Now straighten the left leg out, fully pull through your left leg and draw the right knee and right thigh into your chest. You are going to really feel it onto your left thigh. Pull it in. Keep pressing the knee closer towards your chest and keep extending through your left leg. This is a great hip flexor stretch. If you're feeling too tight on your hip flexor is the long muscle along your thigh attached into your spinal column, which is called the psoas, and it's usually very tight if you're sitting for long hours. Keep pulling the knee in and keep extending the left leg out. Hold here for a few breaths. And let's switch and change. Straighten the right leg and hug the left knee and the left thigh in. Keep extending and reaching with your right leg. Draw the left knee and thigh as close as possible towards your chest. And hold. And just breathe deeply. And from here, we are going to go into single leg stretch into the movement. So draw the right knee into your chest. Extend the left leg out. And the left knee into your chest. Exhale. Inhale and switch and change. Exhale, right leg. Inhale and exhale, left. Inhale and exhale, right. Inhale and exhale, left. Inhale and exhale, right. Inhale and exhale left. Inhale and exhale right. Inhale and exhale left. One more time. Inhale and exhale right. Now lower the left leg onto the surface and lift the right leg into 90 degree. 90 degree leg. Grab the back of your leg and keep pulling it towards you. Now those of you who are feeling too much onto the left thigh, you can choose to bend the left leg. Ideally, I suggest please keep the left leg straight so that you get a deep opening as we are working with the roller. Keep pulling the right leg in. Choose to flex and point with your toes. This is a deep hamstring opener. Stay there. and let's switch and change. Right leg down, left leg up. Lower the right leg towards the floor and keep pulling the left leg in. If you're feeling too much onto the right thigh, you can choose to bend the right leg. Flex and point with your left foot. Stay there, just breathe. And let's go into a movement. Single leg, straight leg stretch. Pull the left leg in. Switch and change. Right leg in. Inhale and exhale. 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 One last set, inhale and exhale. And inhale and exhale. And lower both the legs, keeping the legs bent. From here, just place your right foot over your left thigh into a figure four. Keep pressing your lower back into the surface and hug the left thigh into your chest. Now you are going to tilt from side to side. If you're not able to, the roller is moving, you're not able to maneuver the roller, just stay centered. Doesn't matter if you're not moving from side to side. We will do that later. Just keep pulling the thigh into your chest. Don't bring the right knee closer towards your chest. It should be away. This is a deep glute stretch. Stay there. The first time, it will take you a while to understand. After that, you will be able to gaze what you're supposed to do. Keep pressing through your back into the roller. It is not going to move. So you have to use your core over here. And release the left leg. Now, from here, switch and change. Left foot over your right thigh, figure four. Hug the right knee and the right thigh closer towards your chest and your belly. Even if the roller is moving, it's good. It's giving you a massage onto your back. You can slightly rock from side to side. And release, lower both the legs. And from here, straighten your legs, point your toes towards the floor, stretch your arms behind your head. Give a nice lengthening stretch to your entire frontal body. Soften the ribs in, belly in towards your spine. Keep stretching. Breathe. Chin in towards your chest. And relax. Bend the legs. Turn onto any one side. Come up. And take the roller under your thoracic back. Well done, girls. Come on. Let's go part by part. Thoracic back. Just behind your chest. Interlace your palms. Behind your head. This is what we do with the ball also. But the roller gives us a better massage in terms of reaching towards the deeper layers. So from your elbows by the sides, inhale and just take your head towards the back. Open the elbows to the side. Press your mid back into the roller. Exhale and just lift up. Look towards your knees. Inhale and extend through your upper back towards the floor, elbows out. Exhale and lift up. Inhale and reach back, elbows by the sides. Exhale and reach up. Inhale and open your chest towards the ceiling. Lower your head towards the back. Exhale and up. And two more times. Come on. Inhale and back. Exhale and up. One more time. Inhale and back. Exhale and up. And from here, bring the hands by the sides and start rolling on the roller onto your upper back and mid back. You can even hug your palms under your head if your neck is hurting. Keep massaging it for 1 minute. Go up till your neck, upper back, shoulders, and press into it and just keep rolling. Look towards the sky. Enjoy this. It's not usually the muscles which are giving us trouble when we feel stiffness and tightness in our body. It's usually our softer tissues, our connective tissues, which get entangled and stiffened. Keep massaging. And it's feeling so blissful. Just keep rolling. I know it requires a lot of work, but it's magical later. You can tilt from side to side and massage the lats. Just tilt towards one side and massage your lats. And tilt on the other side and massage your lats. Keep tilting from side to side and do 5 to 6 rounds at least. And release. From here, were you able to do it, all of you? Yes, got the movement, got the work, well done. Surzi, I have taught you this today. You can do it for yourself. On your weekends, foam rolling is very important once a week. Please remember, if you are taking a deep tissue massage by a therapist, then that's great. But otherwise, you don't have that option. Then foam roller is poor man's massage, actually. Let's bring it towards our lower back and massage our hips and lower back. So hands by the side. And roll through your lower back and towards your hip. Palms by the side. Keep the legs bent and just roll over it. And relax. From here, bring the roller under your thighs. Don't roll under your knee joint, please. Okay, the soft ball can be used under the knee joint, not the roller. So this will require some work. You have to pick up yourself and then massage. So lift yourself up, pressurize the palms in the ground and just massage the back of your thighs. Roll. relax. Let's roll under our calves. Anybody having varicosity or bruises or cuts or dry, cracked skin, you're not going to massage that area. Please remember, okay? So once again, lifting yourself and massaging your calves. You can turn from side to side. Turn from side to side. Little bit work will be required, yes. Go on, 5 to 6 rounds more. Not under the knee joint. Well done. From here, we are going to go into back extensions. We are going to do the swan with the roller. So have a look. You will lie down onto your chest and your belly. Place the roller in front of you and rest your wrist onto the roller, palms facing each other, and head towards the floor. As you inhale and exhale, start lifting through your head, neck, shoulder, upper back, and pull the roller in. Keep lifting. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Got it? This is what we are doing. Let's begin. So just look down. Hug the belly in towards your spine. Toes are reaching towards the back of the room. In-breath to prepare yourself. And exhale. Lift up through your head, neck, shoulder, upper back, roll the roller in. In-breath over here. Exhale and roll the roller away. Palms facing each other so that you are rolling the forearm. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. One last time. Inhale and exhale. And stay here and just roll the roller. Stay in the extension and roll the roller. Pull it in and out. Pull it in and out. Pull the roller in and out. And in and out. One more time. In and out. And just bring your head down. Place the arms onto the roller and lift the right leg up. Release. Lift the left leg up. And release. Right leg up and lower. Left leg up and lower. Right leg up, lower. Left leg up, lower. One last time. Right leg up, lower. And left leg up, lower. And slowly start lifting up. Come up. Stretch back. Sit onto your heels. And just watch me this time. We are going to do the cat-cow stretch with the roller, okay? So you're going to come forward. Arch your back. Roll the roller forward. Exhale and sit back. Round through your spine. Pull the roller in. Inhale. Extend, arch your back. Exhale. Inhale. Lift up. Exhale.
Inhale. Just move the roller through your palms. Exhale.
Inhale.
And exhale.
And stay there. And relax.
Okay, let's massage the sides. Well done. So just bring your one leg in front of the bottom leg and you are going to sit on the roller. Sitting with your hip on the roller. The top leg is in front of the bottom leg. And start rolling. Massage your outer butt and your outer thigh. Come on, keep rolling onto it. Most of the women feel very painful on their outer butt. Those are the trigger points for them. Keep massaging. Take the roller under your thigh. Under your thigh. And then massage the outer thigh. Don't massage the outer knee, please. The outer thigh. And slowly from here, turn onto both your thighs. We'll come on the other side. Let us massage both our thighs. Come on your forearms like a plank and start rolling on the roller. Roll the entire area of your thighs. Don't go on the knee joint. Now you will fix the roller under your hip joint and just lie down, draping your body. Hip joint, root of your thigh, this area. Fix the roller over there and just lie down. This is very good for back pain. Just stay there. And slowly come up. Take the roller on the other side for the other hip. Feeling nice? Yes? Okay. Top leg in front. And start massaging your hip. Roll on the roller. See, the foam roller itself is a workout. Don't think that you are doing nothing. You are doing a passive work. No. We are doing lymphatic drainage. So you will feel sweaty. Keep rolling. And it does require some kind of muscular work to maneuver the roller. take it under your thigh and massage. Not under the knee, please remember. That's why I don't ask to buy a harder roller, because women cannot bear it. For men, it's fine. It's too much to bear the pressure on certain areas, especially. Okay, release. Now just watch me. We are going to work on the inner thigh. So you are going to put the roller lengthwise. And you will bend the leg. Lie down onto your chest. Bending the leg. Place the roller onto your inner thigh. Lie down on your chest. And pull the roller away from you and in. Away and in. In this, you can massage the inner knee. Lengthwise, just roll the roller on the inner thigh. Pull it in through your leg and out. In and out. And just rest it over there. Press your inner thigh into it and hold it for a few breaths. You can choose a trigger point which you would like to press and hold. And release. Switch and change on other side. Take it on the other side. Don't press and hold for more than a minute, please. Okay? That's enough. Massaging for 30 to 40 seconds and then holding for 1 minute is more than enough. So lying on your chest and your belly and massaging your other inner thigh. Just keep pulling the roller inwards and outwards. And hold. And slowly come up. We are going to go on the shoulder blades. This is the last for the day. It's very effective. You're going to put the roller lengthwise. Okay? And we are going to lie onto it. Rest your head also on the roller. You are placing the roller on the central line of your body, medial line, that is your spinal column. So the shoulder blades are outside the roller. Lie down onto it. Now what you're going to do is your arms, you're going to open in a goalpost position. Goalpost is this, a L-shaped position of your arms. And you're going to dip one arm down, lift it up, then dip the other arm down and lift up. So you're dipping from the elbow, okay? So dip one arm down. This is for the rotator cuff, your upper arm and the muscles around your shoulders, that is your deltoid, pectorals. Keep dipping one after another. Goalpost arms and dip the arm. This is a very good practice for frozen shoulder as well. Couple of rounds. One last set, one palm each side. And release. From here, just bring the roller under your neck. We have covered every area. So for this practice, actually, we need a longer roller, but it's fine. The standard is this one only. So just lie down with your neck on the roller. And tip the head towards the back and chin in. Head towards the back and chin in. Head towards the back and chin in. And head towards the back, chin in. Just stay there and turn the head from side to side, massaging your neck. If you're feeling too much on the roller, on the neck, you can use a soft ball in this practice. And just stay there, relax. And slowly turn to the side and come up. Well done, everyone. I hope all of you understood what we did. We will do it again next time, once more, so that you actually get the hang of it. But I hope your body is feeling nice. Actually, a complete workout can also be done on the foam roller. We do lots of planks. We do shoulder-based series also on the roller. But let's build onto it. First do this much, and then gradually we can do the workout also on the roller. Okay, I hope you're feeling nice into your tissues and your muscles.
Very nice, wonderful.
Thank you so much. Please do it.